10 years, but I finally developed a good relationship with my body.
Whenever I tan, I wear a chill, custom-made silicone gel mask to keep my eyes from looking puffy. Afterwards, I shower, using a honey almond wash on my ripped body, and an exfoliating spearmint gel on my face. I apply Clinique moisturizer before I shave with a razor and cream by Pore Homme. No cologne on the face ever, as the high alcohol content dries out your skin, makes you look older. My suit today is an 80s drape from Allen Flusser, with a bladed back to accommodate for my impressive physique. My tie is by Valentino Couture. My shoes are by A. Testoni. Underwear by Ralph Lauren. Polished hardwood floors run throughout my apartment. The painting, a David Anika. My television, 30 inches. Digital Toshiba. High contrast, highly defined. Plus, it has picture-in-picture capabilities. Plus, it has freeze frame.
And if all else failed, you would get a sense of patriotism from the popular culture. The movies celebrated democratic values and implicitly reinforced the idea that America was special. But now we're about to enter the 90s, and some things have changed.
My Walkman, with auto-reverse continuous play, is by Sony. I am 26 years old, living in New York City at the end of the century, and this is what being Patrick Bateman means to me.
Start praying. No, 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 no.
look for Friday the 13th, part 7. It's been a while, but someone has checked it out, so I settle for an old favorite.
How many nights for A Nightmare on Elm Street?
3, please.
You sure like this movie?
Well, Wes Craven is an excellent director. And Freddy Krueger, you must admit, has become a cultural icon. Plus the scene with the blood geysers from Johnny Depp's bed. The best.
You've read it 37 times.
And I always find something new in it. Thank you very much. Have an awesome day. Look at history, open the books. There are statues with great looks. There are gods, there are kings. I'm pretty sure I'm the same thing. Beyond boundaries, beyond rules, I've been taught in the best schools. There is little I won't do, I'm not like you. It's how I'm built, it's how I'm wired. I am remote, I am desired. I'm something other than a common man. No, I'm not a common man.
How may I help you?
Can I get $1,000 in crisp $50 bills, please? My gazelle skin wallet's feeling sort of like this, eh?
Of course. Processing.
While I wait for my cash, I notice the words, "Abandon all hope, ye who enter here," scrawled in blood red letters on the side of the chemical bank.
Dispensing. Thank you for your loyalty, Patrick.
No. Thank you. I feel it in my heart that it's all about to start, but I don't know, don't know, don't know. Everything I'm telling you's a dream I'm selling you.
Uh-oh, uh-oh, uh-oh.
You're out of wear that outfit again. Wear a dress, a skirt, or something.
You don't like what I'm wearing?
Oh, come on. You're prettier than that.
Thanks for the compliment, Patrick.
And high heels. I like high heels.
Rise and shine. Don't waste time. Head to your terminals. Head to the pines. Present yourself as someone who knows in which direction.
Have a question for you. Is it proper to wear tasseled loafers with a business suit or not? And don't look at me like I'm insane.
You're not insane, Price. I am. We're sending questions. We're sending questions to GQ. We've got this bet to see who gets into the question and answer column first.
We've already lost, Ben Patton. I was printed in the September issue.
I admit I'm a GQ virgin.
Guys, focus. Loafers with tassels, yes or no? This is important.
Well, McDermott, the tasseled loafer is traditionally a casual shoe. But as long as it's black or cordovan, it's okay.
See, I told you, Craig. I have a question for GQ. If all your friends are morons, is it a felony, a misdemeanor, or an act of mercy if you blow their fucking heads off with a 38 Magnum?
I think that's a valid question. By the way, Price, you're priceless. Now, did any of you assholes read the paper this morning?
You mean the Post?
In the same paper, the same issue. Stories about strangled models, a mafia boss thrown off a tenement building, two socialites on a yacht on the Hudson, murdered with a machete, Nazis, neo-Nazis, mutant alligators in the sewers, cannibalistic humanoid underground dwellers, the ozone layer eroding, blind mole people in the village, Kentucky Fried Rats, baseball players with AIDS,
awful,
kids killed on subway tracks, zoo animals tortured and burned alive by preppies, bridges collapsing, nuclear waste in water towers, a ritualistic murder-suicide at the Apollo, new diseases, my God, dyslexia?
What's your point?
I don't know, Tim. Maybe that somebody should do something before we all...
You can get dyslexia from pussy, I heard.
No, McDermott, you can't. It's not a virus. Oh, shit. Which reminds me, last week when we were at Tunnel...
Wait, when were you guys at Tunnel? And follow-up question, why wasn't I invited?
Calm down, you and Evelyn were at the Milli Vanilli concert. Anyway, I pick up this Vassar chick, tight little hard body. I buy her a couple of champagne keyers, we're sucking face in the chandelier room. I take her back to my place, Ryan.
Go on, Tim, you're rock hard.
Where was Meredith through all this?
Don't be such a prude, Ben Patton. I'm not buying a co-op with the girl. I'm just a guy looking for a hassle-free blowjob.
Aren't we all?
Anyway, we're back at my place. She's got enough champagne in her to make a rhino tipsy. She finally agrees to give me a hand job. But get this, she keeps her glove on.
Classy, Price. Hey, where are we having lunch? Dorsia?
I fucking wish. Not even Van Patten can get us into Dorsia.
Fine, but wherever we go, we need to make a reservation.
Welcome to Pastels, gentlemen.
I'll have the venison with yogurt sauce and fiddlehead ferns with mango slices.
I'll have the monkfish appetizer with squid ceviche and golden caviar, and the Gravlax pot pie with green tomatillo slaw.
Delicious. Good choice.
I'll have the scalloped sausage,
The grilled salmon with raspberry vinegar and a side of the maple guacamole. I'll start with the sashimi with goat cheese, then the smoked duck with endive and sun-dried tomato reduction.
Can you please get rid of these faggy bellinis?
I'll keep mine, thank you. And nothing for me, I'm dieting. And don't look now, but look who just came in.
Who is that? Reed Robinson?
No, it's Nigel Morrison.
That's neither Robinson nor Morrison. That's Paul Owen. Paul! I hear he's taking over the Fisher account.
Confirmed. My secretary told me the same thing.
Fuck! So Paul got the Fisher account? Calm down, babe. And it's a fucking account, not the Shroud of Turin. Paul Owen is wearing a cashmere unbuttoned sports jacket and an Andrew Meza tie. Both impressive.
Do you think he has a power jock strap to go along with that thing?
That's the way that he slipped back his hair. With a part so even and sharp, not even I could pull it off, that truly devastates me.
Hi, fellas.
So I play the only card I can. Guys, new card. Picked him up from the printers yesterday. What do you think?
Whoa, very nice.
Cool coloring. Dairy.
That's bone, Lewis. And the lettering is something called Cillian Rail.
It is very cool, but Cillian Rail is about to be discontinued as a font.
That's such bullshit!
My fellows.
Holy shit!
Magnificent, impressive.
So thick, and yet so light.
The lettering, Romali in the stock,
it's eggshell white.
Don't take chances in the game. It matters what you've drawn. The question's not what's in the name, but what it's printed on.
Showed him my fucking card!
Marcus, what are you doing tonight?
maybe we should grab a drink, catch up, discuss things like the Fisher account.
Great, yes, let's do that. We can go to Dorsia. Have you been?
Yes. I mean, no, I mean, I understand it's quite difficult to secure a reservation.
Yes, I've heard that. Tonight at 8?
Dorsia, just like that. Sure, that would be... Fuck! No, wait, I can't. Maybe you should come with me, Paul. Evelyn Williams is having this dinner party thing at her townhouse.
Evelyn Williams is hot.
Is she?
Yeah, unfortunately she's dating that douchebag, Patrick Bateman. Got her one douchebag.
What is such a douche? I imagine taking a serrated knife and slicing his neck open. Would he finally stop smiling, man?
Here's my card. Have your secretary call my secretary with the details, and I'll see you tonight at Evelyn's.
Paul Owen's business card is nicer than mine. I'm thinking, he can get a reservation at Dorsia, and I can't. I'm thinking, he got the Fisher account, and I didn't. I'm thinking, I am 26 years old, and what? What do I have?
This is a really big birthday for Patrick Courtney, so thanks for being my co-host. Anything for you, Evelyn?
The best of justice.
last minute additions, both of them, for which I am still unbelievably furious with you.
It's good to see you, Courtney. You look very pretty tonight. Your face has a youthful glow.
You really know how to charm the ladies, Bateman, don't you?
You can ignore me all you want, but I'm never forgiving you.
Don't groan, Timothy. I want it tonight to be perfect, not just for Patrick, but for you too. We heard about Meredith.
Do you have a lint brush, Evelyn? For my lint.
It's in my bedroom. You know the way.
Courtney, can you get the Kieran out of the refrigerator, please? But of course.
Evelyn.
All right, fine, I forgive you.
What do you think of Paul?
Oh, God, I don't know. He's fine, I suppose.
He's rich.
Everybody's rich.
He's good looking.
Everybody's good looking.
He's got a great body, great definition.
Yeah, everyone has a great body now, Patrick. But I love you. I love your definition.
Okay, Paul has these business cards.
Yeah, dinner!
So far today, from the second I left my apartment, I counted 23 homeless people. 23?
I've counted 34.
It's shocking. Well, I've counted 42. And what's really shocking is, most of those homeless, faceless 42, most of them want to be out on the streets.
I call bullshit.
No, it's true. Listen, they, for whatever reason, like living outside in this filthy garbage dump of a city. So move. What are you talking about? We're in New York. Where else is there?
I don't know. L.A.? Chicago?
Move and do what?
It's a joke. He's joking. No one lives in those places. Plum wine, Mrs. Bateman.
Wine, Evelyn, from a plum? I don't think so.
Your home is beautiful. What?
It's so nice.
It's fine. For a struggling single girl, it's tolerable. But for a young, authorized couple looking to start a family in the next year or two, well, you know what I'm saying, right, Mrs. Bateman?
Hey, bro. Your fake tan is fucking ridiculous.
Don't listen to him, darling. Your tan is even and appropriate.
So how do you two lovely ladies know each other?
Oh, us? As a matter of fact, kind sir, we went to La Rose together. That's in Switzerland. Then business school in Geneva, also in Switzerland. I barely scraped through, but Courtney, upon graduation, was aggressively recruited by many headhunters. She's smarter than anyone at this table.
Which is why I drink and do lithium.
Where did you go to school, Paul? Christ's sake, just suck his dick, will you? Or... yeah, me too.
Then the London School of Economics.
Fuck you!
John, you were telling me about some article you were working on for that literary journal. What was that about?
The death of downtown.
I'll get it, child.
That sounds like a cool topic. I should definitely check that out.
Why? No one gives a rat's ass about the death of downtown.
Actually, I live downtown.
Yes, and there are some really cool clubs south of 20th. Danceteria, so... hey, if downtown's dying, I care.
About a couple of bars closing? What about current events, huh? What about, like apartheid?
What about it?
Well, we have to end it, for one. And not just apartheid, the nuclear arms race.
Go on.
We need to slow it down, obviously, and stop terrorism as well as world hunger.
Is anyone else starving?
At which point I would shore up our national defense, all the while curbing the spread of communism in Central America, as well as work towards a Middle East peace settlement.
That would be good.
We have to decrease U.S. military involvement overseas, if not prevent it altogether.
Are we forgetting why we're here? It's someone's birthday!
Domestically, we are in trouble. We need affordable health care for the elderly. Also, why is it so hard to control and find a cure for AIDS?
AIDS? Not at the dinner table.
Let's cut down on crime and illegal drugs, especially cocaine. Protect Social Security. We need to stop people from abusing the welfare system, oppose racial discrimination, promote civil rights, while at the same time promoting equal rights for women.
Thanks for that.
The abortion laws have to change to protect the right to life, while somehow maintaining women's freedom of choice. What else? Illegal immigrants.
Patrick!
it's your favorite, darling, red velvet.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Patrick Bateman. Happy birthday to you.
$25.
I have these drink tickets.
After 11, those aren't good anymore. It's a cash bar $25.
Well, can you bring the 50? Because if you can't, I'm gonna stamp you to death and play around with your blonde entrails. No, no, keep the change, beautiful. Hey, Christ, I figured out where they go.
What?
The tracks. They go into the tunnel.
Oh, Jesus, fine. Come on, let's go to the bathroom. You and I need to do some Bolivian marching power, like now.
Well, geez, that's not a hell of a lot, is it? What is Ricardo's problem? He said it was a gram.
Oh, my God.
Hey, what, how is that? It's terrible. It's fucking sweet and low. I mean, it's definitely not the best, but if we do another bit, we should be fine.
I want to get high off this price, not sprinkle it on my fucking all brand.
Goddamn fucking Ricardo!
Bateman, chill. Seriously, what is your fucking problem?
What is my fucking problem?
My fucking problem is
I'm young, I'm skilled, I'm resourceful, and an asset society cannot afford to lose. You hate your job. The world is going insane, and we're getting to the point where our bodies have somehow become attuned to the insanity. It's starting to make sense to us.
There's a flaw in the system. There's a crack in the sky. I've taken the steps, but I'm not feeling high. There's not enough money. There aren't enough girls. Pretty sure those are signs. It's the end of the world.
Maybe it's me, or it's you, or it's us. My head is on fire and there is no because.
Take a deep breath, you're just spinning now. I've got no idea what you're talking about. You don't feel alright, that's not a crime. Enjoy the spoils, ignore the crime.
Somewhere in the center of burning line, we're killing time, we're killing. It's the end of the world. Veil is slipping, it's the end of the world. I'm not just tripping, it's the end of the world. It's crushing at us, it's the end of the world. And none of it matters.
Goodbye, all you-
Hello. Pat Bateman. What's your name?
Al.
Al, did you say? I'll forget. It doesn't matter. Do you want some money? Some food? Is this what you need?
I'm so hungry.
Yeah. It's cold out too, isn't it?
Yes.
Why don't you get a job? If you're so hungry and cold.
I lost my job.
Why? Insider trading? That's a joke. Listen to me, Al. Do you think it's fair to take money from people who do have jobs, who do work?
What can I do?
Do you know what your problem is, Al? You have a negative attitude. Guess what? I'll help you.
You're so kind, mister. I can tell.
Do you know how
sorry.
I'm sorry too, Al. It's just, I don't have anything in common with you.
Devastated.
If
us now. I hope we can go back to being friends again.
Courtney, and don't take this the wrong way, you are a babe. But no sex is worth this bullshit.
Fuck you, you asshole!
That trainer we had this morning, total hard
work. Definitely, man. Great tits, right? Great abs.
I'm not impressed. Did you see her knees?
Her knees? All I want is for some hot chick to sit on my face for 30, 40 minutes. Is that a crime?
Dean McDermott, you're a regular Ed Gein.
Ed Gein? Is he the mayor of Canal Bar?
No. Lewis, Ed Gein, the serial killer, said a lot of interesting things about women.
Jesus Christ, Bateman, not again.
What price? Don't piss me off!
Yeah, he's got a point, though. When you're not talking about your hero, the Donald, you're talking about Son of Sam, or Ted Bundy, or Featherhead, for Christ's sake.
Featherhead? Who the hell is Featherhead?
He means Leatherface, you idiots. Part of the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre, I believe.
That's right, Price. And for the record, Van Patten, The Art of the Deal is not just the best business advice book ever written, it's also an excellent memoir.
Who wants to steam? And then maybe Bateman can tell us all about the Hillside Strangler, too.
Question. Would I ruin everything by strangling Lewis? On the other hand, would the world be a safer, kinder place? The grim truth is, my world might be, so why not?
Jesus, Patrick, why here? I've seen you staring at me. I've noticed your hard body. I don't want this. I wanted this since that Genesis concert we went to. You were wearing that red striped paisley Armani tie.
Can you go away from me, Lewis?
It's cool. I was nervous my first time, too. Nervous, I was terrified. Does Evelyn suspect? I know Courtney doesn't.
I have to go. I have to return some videotapes. Lewis, this didn't happen.
Wait. Patrick, I'll call you.
We're off to the theater. The seats are cheap.
I really hope I don't fall asleep.
Do what?
Get
married! Well, have a wedding.
announced, at my Christmas party, your mom will be there.
Evelyn, darling, are you having a stroke?
I want a 16-foot-tiered Ben & Jerry's ice cream cake. And a gown by Ralph and thousands of roses and Annie Leibovitz! And someone to videotape it, so it's real.
If we get married, we'll make a new life.
Having a nightmare where you are my wife.
Like a huge diamond, let's settle for less.
How many carats, or should I just guess? If you only knew.
Drinking.
Now, would either of you ladies like to know what I do for a living?
Not really. Are you a model?
No, flattering, but no. I work on Wall Street at Pierce & Pierce. Have you heard of it?
Sure. It's a shoe store, right?
It's an investment bank.
What do you do there?
I'm into murders and executions, mostly. Depends.
Do you like it?
I don't know. It depends. Why do you ask?
Because most guys I know who work in mergers and acquisitions don't really like it.
Yes, but see, I handle a very important account, the Fisher account, and anyway, that's not what I said. What I said. Oh, forget it. Let's just get started. Did you like it?
I
loved it.
Oh, me too. I thought it was so beautiful and emotional, especially Fantine's Tour de Force solo, I Dreamed a Dream, which it's safe to say could be one of the most important ballads of the 20th century.
Yeah, I know. I cried. It's such an uplifting human story.
Isn't it? And the innkeeper and his wife, they were hilarious. I can't get that song, Master of the House, out of my head. So witty.
So, big plans for Christmas?
I'm hanging with family, escorting my mother to Evelyn's Christmas party.
I thought you two were in a lover's spat or something.
We were. But then this kind of existential chasm opened up in front of me while I was shopping at Bloomingdale's and, I don't know. 'Tis the season.
Well, this is for you. Merry Christmas, Patrick.
Merry Christmas, Jean. As with many people, the holidays are a difficult time for me, so I bolster myself with daily viewings of Silent Night, Deadly Night, a superb movie about an axe-wielding Santa. I lace my hot apple cider with copious amounts of drugs and alcohol to dull the screaming. And I prepare my apartment for a Christmas Eve bacchanal bloodbath. Who's? I don't know yet, but that's my Christmas present to myself.
Jesus Christ, Merry Xmas, Paul.
Merry Xmas, Paul.
How long have you been, Halberstam? Workaholic, I suppose.
You know me. When you workaholic, just close down shop for the holidays. One last meeting at the Knickerbocker. Now here I am at Evelyn Williams' Christmas party.
Evelyn Williams is still dating
that douchebag Patrick Bateman, so I hear.
That it is.
Is Cecilia here tonight?
She has the flu.
Ooh, say, Marcus, it's pretty dead here. What do you say we cut out together?
Oh, but the Christmas midgets are about to sing Old Tannenbaum.
You still hankering for Dorcia? Amazing sea urchin there this time of year.
Yeah, great. Let's do that. But first, let's swing by my place.
Do you have a dog, a chow, or something?
No.
I put them down in case I killed Courtney, Evelyn, or Lewis tonight, but that was before.
Before?
I am utterly insane, Paul. I like to dissect girls.
It's fine.
I used to hate Iggy Pop too, but now that he's more commercial, I like him.
You're both 27 years old. Did you know that?
Hit the bees!
Taking the Fisher account to the next level. This is something business related. You can reach me at my office. I packed one of Paul's Ralph Lauren suitcases with a double-breasted suit from Brooks Brothers, Paul's passport, and an assortment of toiletries. Then I head back to my place, where Paul's body is already in rigor mortis. I zip him up in a Canalino Goose Down sleeping bag. I got the Conrad's on sale.
Would you like a hand with that, Mr. Bateman?
Thank you. Lloyd, I've ordered a car.
I believe it's idling by the delivery entrance. I'll get this loaded, then have it circle around to the front.
Thank you, Lloyd. Oh, and Lloyd, my secretary sent you an envelope, didn't she, for a little something for Christmas?
Yes, sir. The car was beautiful. Mark Kostabi, wasn't it? Thank you, sir.
This is what happens next. I take the thing that was once Paul Owen to an apartment I own anonymously in an abandoned building at Hell's Kitchen. I place it in an oversized porcelain tub. I pour a bag of lime over it. I watch as it dissolves into anonymity. And then I take the car, which I had waiting for me back home. I am relieved that no one has seen me. But in the elevator going up, Merry Christmas. It's great, isn't it, this building? Your penthouse must be.
I like it.
I thought you were very good at Top Gun. I thought that was quite a good movie. And Bartender also. I thought that one was exceptional. Pardon? Oh yeah, Cocktail, that's right. Anyway, I'm a big fan. It's nice to finally meet after living in the same building for so many years.
Right.
You know, I have that same pair of aviators. A lot of people say we look alike.
I don't see it.
December slides into January, which mutates into February, which creeps towards March. There is a theory that obliterating Paul might have satisfied something. Continue to have intense dreams of vivisection, and my nightly bloodlust overflows into my waking life.
Hey, pretty girl, you wanna dance? You wanna get lucky? This is your chance. The drinks are on me. Can I be friends?
What do you do for a living? Don't answer that.
I don't care.
I'm just kidding. You can ignore my friends at the bar. They're trying to score, but they never get far.
With some girl, I forget her name. She thinks we're in love, but she thinks I'm insane. She's not more than just kind of annoying. That's a fine Chardonnay that you're not enjoying. Oh, never mind, let's quit this dive. A white M3 is parked outside. We'll call my dealer, his product is clean. Fuck, I don't wanna drive. Let's get a limousine.
Thank you.
Sarah!
Patrick, she's here. She's your mother.
I can't face her, Jean. 2 hours alone.
I'll go with you.
You?
Yeah, if you want. I mean, I'd like to get to know Patrick Bateman's mother.
Jean, that is a brilliant idea. Do we need reservations?
I've already made some, darling. A tavern on the green.
After lunch, we sit in the park.
We take the train into the city. Patty and I. Oh, he loved visiting the Egyptian mummies at the Met.
Me too. I mean, I only went to the Met once when I was 12 with my sister, but we spent all day there. Every room was like this universe.
For one brief moment, I imagined myself with Jean. We're holding hands, running ahead of my mother across the great lawn. By balloons, we let them go, watch them float into the sky.
You know, darling, if you married this one, maybe you would be less unhappy.
I'm not unhappy, Mom. Anyway, Jean would never marry someone like me, would you, Jean?
So, what other secrets can you tell me about Patrick from when he was growing up?
Don't answer that, Mom.
Well, he was perfect. My perfect little angel. He was a beautiful child. He made me laugh. He made me smile. A golden path was paved. Still, he was so well behaved. And it's a funny thing. He loved to dance, he loved to sing. Such beautiful blonde curls. I knew one day he'd rule the world.
It's a nice thought. Patrick as a little child, playing at the seaside, his spirit free, his laughter.
Sorry to barge in. I should have made an appointment. I'm Donald Kimball.
Patrick Bateman. Pat. Bateman. What is the topic of discussion today, Detective?
I'm investigating the disappearance of Paul Owen.
I see. Well, I haven't heard anything about that. I mean, it hasn't been on page 6, at least.
These are just preliminary questions for my files. What's your address, Mr. Bateman?
55 West 81st Street, the American Gardens Building.
Nice! Very nice!
Thank you.
Doesn't Tom Cruise live there?
You know, he does. The penthouse. In fact, I was just talking to Tom. Well, I guess it was a few months ago now. Christmas Eve, in fact. God, Jesus. Time dies, flies. Time flies.
Christmas Eve is the night Paul Owen went missing.
Is it? Well, I was at my girlfriend's Christmas party that evening, and then I bumped into Tom later in the night.
Your girlfriend is Evelyn Williams?
Yes, which she would happily corroborate if you ask her.
That won't be necessary, Mr. Bateman. What can you tell me about Paul Owen?
Well, the thing about Paul is, he was part of that whole Yale thing.
The Yale thing being?
Well, I think for one, Paul is probably a closeted homosexual who does a lot of cocaine. That Yale thing.
But what kind of man was he?
I hope I'm not being cross-examined here.
Do you feel that way?
Paul Owen lived an ordinary life, Detective. As far as I know, he ate a balanced diet.
There's a message on Paul's answering machine saying he went to London.
The Fisher account, that makes sense.
But his girlfriend doesn't think so.
Have you consulted a psychic?
No, but that's a good idea.
And do you suspect foul play?
Can't say. It's so strange, though. One day someone's walking around, going to work, alive, and then
the earth,
the what?
The earth just opens up and swallows people, I guess. People just disappear. It's eerie.
Listen, I've taken up enough of your time.
Well, I do have an early lunch with Cliff Huxtable at the Four Seasons, so.
Here's my card, Mr. Bateman. If anything occurs to you, any information at all.
Nice.
Nothing special.
Say, Detective, there couldn't be a connection between Paul's disappearance and all these murders I keep reading about.
You know about those?
Well, I've been following them. I'm a bit of a buff about serial killers. Ed Gein, Ted Bundy. That's what we're dealing with here, isn't it?
Yes, but we're getting close to catching him, Mr. Bateman. We think he's been working for years, but the last few months he's been getting sloppy, careless. Only a matter of time now.
Good. Good luck with that, Detective.
Let's be in touch, Mr. Bateman.
Already this year, there have been 4 major air disasters, all caught on videotape. And the new Oscar de la Renta deodorant I've started using is giving me a slight rash. The talking ATM on 72nd has started to say things to me like,
"Feed me a stray cat."
Last night, I killed a woman, not a prostitute, in my apartment. Am I trying to get caught? Jean, what are my next 2 weeks like? Can you clear them for me and get me Evelyn?
Of course. This is Evelyn.
Evelyn, it's bone season. I think we should go away.
Who is this?
It's Patrick.
Oh.
I just need to lay low for a couple of weeks. You think we could go somewhere?
Oh, baby, I wish we could. It's just that ever since this stupid promotion...
I just feel like we've been losing touch, Evelyn. I want us to reconnect.
Oh, honey! Well, in that case, I know just the thing! The Hamptons! Well, our chums will be there. We'll stay in Tim's. I'll book us a helicopter.
As in an aircraft?
Well, what would you have us do, Patrick? Rent a Volvo?
surfing. We talk about romantic things like the moonrise in October over the hills of Virginia. We take bubble baths in Tim's big marble tub, go skinny dipping in the ocean, snuggle under cashmere blankets. But something is off. I fantasize about drowning Evelyn in the tub, wrapping her body in the blanket and dragging it into the surf. Did I do that already?
The garden party. My dress and stripes.
This place is infested with familiar types. At night, I roam the beaches digging up baby crabs under a sky so clear I can see the entire solar system and the sand dunes lit by it seem almost lunar in scale.
Where should we go for dinner tonight, darling? Nick and Tony's?
This morning, pre-dawn, I microwaved a beach jellyfish and devoured half of it.
Oh, you're right. I am gaining weight out here.
All the characteristics of a human being. Flesh, blood, skin, hair. But my depersonalization is intensifying. There isn't, I come to accept, a clear, identifiable emotion within me. It was a mistake to leave my natural habitat.
We like it like this. We're tan and smooth.
Exactly is the difference between distilled and purified water? Does anyone know?
Well, with purified water, most of the minerals have been removed. The water has been boiled and the steam condensed into, ergo, purified water. Distilled water, on the other hand, has a flat taste and usually is not for drinking.
And sparkling water gets its fizz from carbon dioxide, right?
Yes.
I knew it. What are you thinking about, darling?
The body I left back home in my apartment.
Yeah, I know. I'm worried about my mail. I wonder if it's piling up.
I could take it to the apartment in Hell's Kitchen the way I did with Paul's, but I want to keep the men's bodies separate from the women's out of respect. You never met Victoria, did you, my neighbor? I bumped into her in the dry cleaners. She'd been sniffing around me for months, so I invited her up to my apartment.
Patrick! Who hung this painting?
I did, Victoria. It's an Annika. You like it?
I do, but Patrick, I'm pretty sure you hung it upside down.
What?
Yes, you hung your Annika upside down. I can't believe that. How funny. Did you do that on purpose?
She annoyed me, so I crucified her with an Annika.
All right, smart guys.
My trainer says Gatorade is good.
Isn't spring water the best replacer since it enters the bloodstream faster than any other liquid?
I was afraid to try Pellegrino for the first time. But then, once I did, it was fine.
Wine coolers in the fridge, steaks on the grill, Whitney on the stereo.
Just the same, you know, as that boy I met at that mixer in college. I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing. Let's say good.
The past isn't real, Evelyn. It's just a dream. Don't mention the past.
What has gotten into you?
I've realized my need to engage in homicidal behavior on a massive scale cannot be corrected. Coming out here, I thought...
I think it would help if you made a firm commitment.
Maybe. Maybe to what?
To us! To our future, together!
Evelyn, you're missing the essence.
what I'm saying. I have a severely impaired capacity to feel.
I know! What I'm saying is I do too.
That antique weather vane that Tim has hung over the fireplace in there, I'm wondering if I could use it to kill people.
Marry me, Patrick! Marry me and let's find that out together!
Why not agree and end up with this girl? If we can go back to New York today, this afternoon, in a helicopter.
Anything you want, my darling.
And that protects me.
Well, then let's get you back there.
Thank God, New York City, that Long Island is pretty shitty. Back to my old haunts.
Thank you. This whole thing with Evelyn, marrying her, it's insanity! I can't keep going on like this.
Louis, get your hands off of me!
Listen.
No,
listen! I know you have the same feelings I do, so why? Why can't we be together?
Louis, you pathetic little faggot! If you don't stop with this bullshit, I'll slit your fucking throat right here in Barnes!
Wait, Patrick! I figured it all out! I don't have to marry Courtney. You don't have to marry Evelyn. We can relocate to Arizona and buy an inn!
What the fuck? You're marrying Courtney?
Not if we go away together.
You are truly the only person more insane than I am.
I love you, Patrick. I love you.
I'm convinced, Louis. You convinced me. Now, have the guts to face reality. I don't love you. I don't love anyone.
You're marrying Evelyn.
That's different.
What can I say, Patrick? Time is running out for all of us, and I want to have children. But what? Only you get to be happy.
But for the millionth time, Louis is a fan!
No, he is not, Patrick! Why do you always say that?
Because in college, he used to let frat guys tie him up and gangbang him at parties and stuff!
Oh my God, Patrick! College!
I'm trying to save your life, you dumb bitch!
Oh, well, that's nice. Good. Bye, Patrick. Do me a favor. Don't call me again! Patrick, is everything all right?
Gene, fine! Everything is fine.
You were yelling.
Gene, do you want to accompany me to dinner, Gene? If you're not doing anything tonight.
Yeah, I have no plans.
Oh, isn't that a coincidence? Where would you like to go?
I don't know, it doesn't matter.
Come on, anywhere you want, I can get us in.
What about Dorcia?
So, Dorcia is where Gene wants to go. Gene is just like everyone else.
No, I don't know. We'll go wherever you want.
No. Dorcia is what you want. Dorcia is what you deserve. Well, let's stop at my place for a drink beforehand. Would you like that, Gene?
Sure, if you want to.
Well, I'm not staying with you right now, visiting your sister.
No, it's just me.
Perfect. So I'll see you at my place, then. Take the rest of the day off. Go home, get changed, wear something, I don't know, special. Let's make this a special night.
Okay.
He doesn't sound right. His voice a little thin. Does he need someone the way that I need him? Does everything he has amount to enough?
like to travel? Or maybe go back to school?
I don't really know. I'm at a point in my life where there seems to be so many possibilities, but I'm so...
What, did I say something wrong?
No. No, it's just what you just said about possibilities. Reminded me of a girl I knew in college once.
A first love? Anyway, I'm a bit unsure about the future.
I just want to have a meaningful relationship with someone unique, you know?
That makes sense.
To live happily ever after, right? That's what he wants, I want.
That's why people need each other, I guess. To be happy.
Some don't. Well, people adjust to their circumstances.
You're not one of those people, Patrick.
Oh, Jean. Where you see nature and earth, life and water, I see an unending desert landscape devoid of light and reason and spirit.
But I mean, haven't you ever wanted to make someone happy?
What? What was that?
Haven't you ever wanted to make someone happy? Evelyn? Or someone else?
Did you know, Jean, that Ted Bundy's first dog, a collie, was named Lassie? Had you heard that?
Who's Ted Bundy?
Forget it. You were saying. Please. Go!
Patrick.
there's an idea of Patrick Bateman. Some kind of abstraction. There is no real me, only an entity. This entity. Detective Campbell, Patrick Bateman, you came to see me about Paul Owen's disappearance. And though you can shake my hand, you can feel my flesh gripping yours, I simply am not there. I killed Paul Owen, Detective, with an axe, and not just Paul, dozens and dozens of people, too many to count, most of them women, you can't imagine. The truth is, it's hard for me to make sense on any given level. I am fabricated an apparition. I can tell you where the bodies are, Detective. I keep some of them in an apartment in Hell's Kitchen, but lately I've been using, you'll appreciate this, Paul Owen's apartment as a meat locker. My conscience, my pity, my hope, it all disappeared a long time ago. Probably at Harvard, if it ever existed. There are no more barriers to cross, no more frontiers. I am without limit. And I'm a pretty sick guy, Detective. And I almost hurt someone good. So I think you might have to stop me. Or something. When you get this message, calling HR this AM. You're getting a promotion. You deserve
deserve it for putting up with all of my bullshit. And a better benefits package. I want to make sure that you are taken care of.
Patrick, I don't know what to say.
Just say yes, Jean.
Yes.
Thank you, Jean. For everything. Immediately, you'll be the one taking it to the next level. And by the way, I wasn't supposed to say anything, so act surprised when they tell you.
Okay.
Will. I am. Hey, we should celebrate. Get the whole sick crew together. What do you say, pal? Tunnel, for old time's sake. You were working as a waitress in a cocktail bar.
For a change.
What did you have in mind, Bateman?
Oh, Carruthers. Maybe. Where do we have reservations?
God, Patrick, when did you become such a control freak?
Oh, I always feel better when I know where I'm going next. McDermott, 222, check the Zagat.
No fucking way. The cold guy scored there last time was cut with so much less.
Whoa, what up? Jesus. No point in the night much.
I can call Dorcia and get us in.
Dorcia? Ooh la la.
I highly doubt that. Show me.
Maynard D was one of my roommates. Freshman year, you ass. Deal with it. So should I call?
Yes. Patrick, is Dorcia all right?
Come on, Bateman. We're waiting.
Excuse me. I have to return some videotapes.
Patrick, it's Dorcia. We're going.
Detective Kimball?
Mr. Bateman, how are you? Having a night out?
I am, yes. A rockin' and a rollin'. But I thought I might hear from you.
About?
Did you get my message? The one I left you, sort of rambling confession.
Oh, God, yes, that was, so that was you. Oh, Mr. Bateman, I have to tell you, that was hilarious. You killing all of them, and the escort girls and all the others, that was brilliant. You're a very talented man. You should be an actor.
Detective, you don't seem to understand. That whole message I left you.
Yes.
It's true. I tortured and killed dozens and dozens of people. I killed Paul Owen and chopped him up. And also, I liked it a lot. Really can't be any clearer than that.
Mr. Bateman, that's just not possible.
Why isn't it possible?
because I had dinner with Paul Owen in London, where he is indeed hiding out.
What?
I found him and had dinner with him twice, in fact.
And he was, like, alive?
Oh, very much so. And mortified about the whole thing. Apologized for wasting my time. Bought me tickets to Les Mis on the West End. Excellent show, by the way, if you haven't seen it.
Okay, but what about the escort girls? Did you go to Paul Owen's apartment? Did you see their bodies, the blood on the walls?
I have been to Paul Owen's apartment, Mr. Bateman. Just today, in fact. Have you?
Maybe this isn't
am I just a version of the end of days? Am I just an effect of a modern phase? Am I just the end point of the grand parade?
This is what being Patrick Bateman means to me.